Hello and welcome all of you to the class of Database Management Systems. I am Dr. Shankar, Professor and Head, Department of CSE, Hindustan College of Engineering and Technology. This class is intended to provide an introduction to Database Management Systems and all the basic and important concepts in Database Management Systems. I welcome once again all of you to the class of DBMS. The content that is going to be covered in this class includes the stages of information system, introduction to database system, history of DBMS, need of DBMS, goal of DBMS, applications of DBMS, drawbacks of file system versus DBMS, characteristics of the database approach, advantages of DBMS. So these are the various topics that we are going to cover in this class. Stages of information system, or in other words, it can be called as evolution of the information system over the period of time. Stage 0 was the manual information system, wherein people maintain physical or manual records of everything, like records, files, index cards, etc. Then from stage 0, people moved on to stage 1, wherein the sequential information systems came into picture. It includes magnetic tapes, magnetic files, etc. to store the information. The drawback of the sequential information system is that it is slow, it is non-interactive, and it is also redundant. Then people move on from stage 1 to stage 2, wherein file-based information systems came into picture. It used disk, which supports direct access or random access, compared to files and tapes, which supports only sequential access. Then here, the application program has its own file. Each and every application program has its own file. Therefore, data dependence is there, which is again a drawback. Then, data redundancy is one more drawback that is there in the stage 2, that is the file-based information systems. Then, over a period of time, people move from stage 2 to stage 3, where actually the DBMS came into existence. DBMS stands for Database Management System. So, DBMS-based information systems came into existence. Here, the highlight is that we have a centralized data management software, and also transaction processing is done. In other words, the transaction processing systems are called as OLTP systems. So here OLTP stands for Online Transaction Processing. So the DBMS based information systems has a generalized data management software as well as it supports the online transaction processing, OLTP. So these are the various stages of the information system. We move from stage 0 to stage 3, where actually the DBMS came into existence. So now we move on to the definition of database management system, or what actually is a database management system. Database management system, in short, it is abbreviated as DBMS, is a software for storing and retrieving users' data while considering appropriate security measures. It consists of a group of programs which manipulate the database. So in short, we can refer DBMS as a combination of database and management system. Here you can see DBMS is equal to database plus management system. So it can be divided into two parts. The first part is the database, and the second part is the management system or the software that manages the database. So we will consider the parts one by one. The first part is database. So database is actually a collection of data, a group of data or collection of data or we can see a collection of related data or interrelated data is called as a database. The second part is the management system. That is nothing but the software that manages the database, which is called as a management system. These two things put together is only called as the database management system or DBMS. Again, we shall get into more details about the database management system. So as I told you, management system is a set of programs to store and retrieve those data. So the data will be stored into the database, and later on when need arises, it has to be retrieved back from the database by the application programs. So again, we will see one more finer definition for DBMS. So DBMS by definition is a database management system, and it is a collection of interrelated data, as I told you, and a set of programs to access those data. So database plus the management software. Database is the set of interrelated data, and the management software is a set of programs to access those data. This is called as a DBMS. And in the right hand side, you can see a diagrammatic representation, which is actually a layered approach. The bottommost layer, we have something which is called as a storage area segment. The storage area segment is the bottommost layer. In that, we have the relational database, hierarchical database, flat files database, objects database, etc. The various types of database or the storage area has been shown there. And just above that, we have the DBMS or the DBMS software, which accesses the middle layer. And the DBMS software is used for defining the data, it is used for recording the data, integrating, updating, and also managing the data. It is the software. Then the topmost layer is the applications that interact with the DBMS. So we have software applications, we have other DBMS that are interacting with this DBMS, we have the users or the end users or different types of users who are interacting with the DBMS. So this is the layered architecture approach. So the bottommost layer, we have the storage area, and the middle layer, we have the DBMS, and the top layer, we have the applications. So this is how the interaction takes place through the database management system. Next comes the history of DBMS. So as I told you, we have different generations of DBMS, like first generation, second generation, and third generation. So first generation of DBMS, what is there in the first generation of DBMS? So we have models like hierarchical model, in short it is called as IMS, the information management system, that comes under the hierarchical model. Then we have another model which is called as a network model, and under network model we have conference on data system languages, which is called as CODASIL, and we also have DBTG, which is nothing but the database task force or the database task group, that is DBTG. So this is the first generation. Basically we have hierarchical model and network model. And then the second generation, in that we have the relational model, the most popular model even nowadays we are using, that the relational model, or it can also be called as the RDBMS, the relational model, or RDBMS, relational database management system. And this model was discovered by Edgar F. Codd. So he is the scientist behind this model, who gave a set of rules which is called as the Codd's rules. And once a database satisfies the Codd's rules, it can be called as a relational database management system. And this follows a model which is called as a relational data model. So examples of the databases are the real-time databases that follows this model, or DB2, which is nothing but from the company IBM, IBM DB2, Oracle, a famous company which is having a huge market share across the world for database management systems. So these real-time database management systems like IBM DB2 and Oracle are popular examples which follow the relational data model. Then we move on to the third generation of DBMS, wherein we have object relational DBMS and the object oriented DBMS. So this object oriented DBMS is called as OODBMS, object oriented DBMS, and this object relational DBMS is called as ORDBMS, object relational database management system. So these are the various generations of the DBMS, or the history of the DBMS, or the evolution of the DBMS over the period of time. Then next comes the need for DBMS. Why actually we have to move to DBMS, or what is the necessity for DBMS? Earlier we had file systems, then why we moved from file systems to the database management system? Database systems are basically developed for large amount of data or huge amount of data. A database management system is a system software for easy, efficient and reliable data processing and management. So it is a software which is made for easy, efficient and reliable data processing. So when dealing with huge amount of data, there are two things that is required for optimization: storage of data and retrieval of data. So we have to efficiently store the data, as well as we have to efficiently and fastly retrieve the data to the application programs. So these are the two basic objectives why we should have a DBMS: the storage of data and retrieval of data. Also, easily and efficiently and reliably we can be able to handle the huge volumes of data using a DBMS. So this is the need why actually a DBMS was developed and why people moved from file system to a more reliable database management system. It can easily and efficiently handle huge volumes of data, and it can take care of the storage and retrieval of data in an efficient manner. So again, the need for DBMS, it can be used for creation of a database, retrieval of information from the database, data redundancy can be eliminated or minimized when we go for a DBMS, data integrity is ensured, updating the database is taken care, managing of a database is done by the DBMS software, data security is ensured, and data indexing is done for fast and efficient storage and retrieval of the data. So these are the various tips or various advantages of the DBMS over the file system. That is why we need a DBMS, or we go for a DBMS. Goal of DBMS. What is the goal of DBMS, or what is the objective of the DBMS? The primary goal of DBMS is to provide a way to store and retrieve database information efficiently, which I already told you. Management of data involves both structures for storing information and mechanism for manipulation. Again, basically storing and retrieving, the indexing mechanisms and everything comes into picture. So this is our basic goal or basic objective of a DBMS: to store and retrieve a data in an efficient manner. Next, we move on to the applications of DBMS. So there are various applications, or various real-time or real-world applications of the DBMS. You can see over there, DBMS is used in many places across the world, like railway reservation system, library management system, banking system, universities and colleges, credit card transactions, social media sites, telecommunication systems, finance, military applications, online shopping, human resource management, manufacturing, airline reservation system. So everywhere the DBMS is used. In all these real-time applications, the database plays a crucial role, or the DBMS plays a crucial role, without which these applications cannot be powered or made use of. Okay, even the social media websites like social media sites like Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook, everywhere the DBMS is applied. Telecommunication industry like Airtel, Jio, everywhere the DBMS is applied. Online shopping sites like Amazon, Flipkart, everywhere the DBMS is applied. And all the reservation systems makes use of the DBMS. Again, the applications of the DBMS, as I told you, is applied in banking services, airlines, insurance sector, credit card transactions, e-commerce applications, education, everywhere the BBMS is used. So these are the things that we have discussed in today's class. Hope it gives you a clear picture about the introduction to the database management systems or DBMS. See you all in the future class. Thank you.